the whole skywalk is actually vibrating with every footstep you feel here. It's not glass yet.
Hi everybody, I'm Budi, also known as the Creative Globetrotter. I'm traveling the world since 2015, an ongoing mission to share you my travel adventures. In this episode, I take you to the Central Eurasia Caucasus region. This country is an amazing blend of cultures, religions and people. The Asian Silk Road marks the country to this day. This country has so much to offer, like Les Green Hills, historic places, good food, amazing mountains, and the ideal cities and villages to spend your time in. This is the Georgia Travel Guide, how to spend a couple of weeks in this Eurasian country. From Istanbul, I took a 2.5 hour flight to Tbilisi, the capital of Georgia. If you have some problems to find this country on the internet, you might check the country's original name, Sakartvelo. You got many sources where the name's coming from ancient languages to the local tribes, or from the patron saint, Saint George. Saint George still stands today on the column on the Independence Square in Tbilisi. My first day I spent in Georgia was walking on Rustavella Avenue to the old town.
So I arrived last night in Georgia, so I couldn't show you anything, but it's tomorrow, the next day. And it will be a very interesting day, it's a bit rainy. But yes, let's see what the city of Tbilisi has to offer.
Tatya is one of my Georgian friends. She lives in Tbilisi and she was my guide to show me around the city.
Now taking the bus, this is my friend. Tasha, you show me around the entire Tbilisi. Just go out to the downtown center, the museums, you will understand.
The old town of Tbilisi is nice and cozy town, divided by the Kura River. Getting lost in a maze of historic streets with typical balconies in the unrenovated or renovated town. See different religious places like churches and cathedrals, and eating some snacks and food in the many dining places. Crossing the bridges in between and going uphill to have different viewpoints on the city, like Nikola Fortes, Georgian Lady Statue, or from the TV Tower viewpoint.
And I are here. This is the nice view from Tbilisi. I already tried it from the fortress, but this is way better. We went up really up top of the mountain, near the TV station here. And it's beautiful.
Not only the historic part of the city is very nice to visit, Tbilisi has several other different highlights, like museums, parliament buildings, and markets and hospitality, because hospitality is one of the best things you can experience in Georgia. How my large group of Georgian friends received me with open arms and eat some good food.
I'm standing here with my Georgian hard of hearing friends, yay!
I'm so curious what we're eating now.
Okay.
If you know more about Tbilisi, check the extended Tbilisi travel guide on this channel. It gives you a great insight of the city, rich cultural heritage and how to get around in the city. It was time to leave Tbilisi and going up straight north to the Kazbegi region, near the border with Russia and the autonomous region of South Ossetia.
We checked out in the Marco Polo hostel. It was a really nice hostel here now on the road to Rusta Valley. Now headed to the metro station to Didup metro station, and from there I take the bus or share taxi to Kazbegi. Let's see how that goes.
In Tbilisi I took the metro to Didup bus station. All traffic from this station go north, west or east of the country. Beware if you travel in Georgia by Maastrichtka bus, the bus leaves when the bus is full.
As told, I get approached again by a lot of people, so I've got a minivan now. It will stop at 3 points and then we go off to Casbeggy. Everything is alright here.
When the taxi van is full, the driver went off one way for 20 lari. It would roughly take 3 hours to enter Casbeggy, following the old military highway. On our way to Casbeggy, we saw very interesting landmarks.
I'm now at Ananui Fortress, it's near the dam, it's 20 kilometers down. It looks really nice, really old school, nice. However, it's a bit too short because our taxi driver wants just 10 minutes to be here. I actually want to stay longer. Our friend for today, our driver, he's doing a really good job, right? Are you?
Yes.
Well, we're almost at Casbeggy. I think maybe 1 hour more ride. This is a very special place. This is actually the Friendship Monument. It's called the Russian-Georgian Friendship Monument or Georgian-Russian Friendship Monument because of the friendship between Georgia and Russia. It's a very colorful building. It's huge. It's very famous when you go along to Casbeggy. But between the tensions being rising up, between the last 10 years between Georgia and Russia, it's still standing up. So there's hope for the future. Arrived at Casbeggy. I'm now in Gegeti, a small village next to Casbeggy region, and I'm off to my hostel or guest house. I've got a real good look on the mountains here. It looks really, really beautiful.
After I check in the hostel, I walk my way up to the Trinity Church near Gegeti town.
I've reached the top. Well, you can't see Mount Casbeggy because behind the clouds. I hope tomorrow clear. You're gonna see the top because otherwise the whole way is here actually for nothing.
The next day, I walk the one-way hike to Mount Casbeg and the Gegeti Glacier.
Today I had to give it another shot and you see there are no clouds at all. So hopefully when I reach the glacier, I see Mount Casbeggy in total.
Beware, this is one of the toughest hikes and hardest hikes I did. Even some trekkings in the Andes and Himalayas are easier. It got an elevation of 1600 meters. You go up 3200 meters to reach the foot of the glacier and you walk 20 kilometers in a return trip, all in all 8 hours in total.
Getting tougher because of my lungs, but just take it slower. I got this already for three weeks, so not an excuse, but just take it slower. Made it 4.5 hours. Hey, I'm really on the glacier itself. It is however very slippery. See, I don't have any spikes. People are going up. No, I'm not doing that. I'm done for today. Have a break. Enjoy the scenery and then go down. Come back to me. Come back to me.
The next day, it was time to leave beautiful Casbeggy region back to Tbilisi. I had a half day to spend my time again in the Georgian capital before I took the night train to Sukdidi.
So I'm here with Uzi, my Israeli friends, walking to the metro station, taking the night train to Sukdidi. So we'll be a whole adventure, and now we take the metro. Let's go, hey?
Yep. Yes.
This is our train, guys. Let's go up on the train.
Yes, here I am in the cabin in the train. We just made it barely because I went out for a drink with some Israeli guy and we have to run for the train, but anyway, we found it. We're here, so I'll see you tomorrow in Sukdidi.
Good morning! I had a really bad sleep on the train, but anyway, we're here at Sukdidi and we're taking out a bus to Mestia.
From Sukdidi, I travel by Maschutska bus 3 hours to Mestia. Mestia is settled in one of the isolated regions near the Russian border called Svaneti. This alpine region of the Caucasus is good for outdoor activities like hiking and mountain biking. Keep in mind, Georgian drivers are crazy drivers. Overtaking and speeding in the most impossible spots is a common thing.
I arrived at Mestia.
Mestia itself is not big, but your time here is well spent. Hike around different trails or take a cable car up to the mountain.
So when you are in Mestia, it's always good to take the cable car hill or up mountains to enjoy the beautiful view.
The next following day, it was time to do a long hike.
I spent yesterday a whole day in Mestia itself. It was kind of a lazy day, so you will walk around a bit. But now I am really head off for a real hike today. Not the hike to Uskuli, because a lot of people do that in a couple of days, but I don't have the time for it. So I'll probably take tomorrow a shared taxi to Uskuli itself. It will be a rainy day also, so it wouldn't be really really nice. So I'm heading off now to the Salati Glacier. So that's a more decent hike, moderate hike, not that hard like in Kazbegi. I hope so. I'm up for the challenge, nice weather. So see you up there. I left Mestia and the smaller and other villages behind. You see that? Now heading off really into the nature itself, towards the massive mountains and lakes. There's already the glacier. Still hike up for 1.5 hours, I think, when I really reached the foot of the glacier. So still has a long way to go. I'm not going further, it's really up to the ice. It's really dangerous, often falling rocks. I know that from my previous tours and trekkings. You see it, a big chunk of ice there, the whole black thing. Yeah. Reach a foot of the glacier, 2.5 hours, all the way from the village. Not bad. kind of cold. Really glacial water. Ice cold.
As predicted, the day after was a rainy day, and it was a good time to take a day trip to Uskuli, one of the historic remote villages in the Svaneti region, and it is on the UNESCO heritage list.
So I arrived here in rainy Uskuli. It took 2 hours from Mesia, really on a dirt, bad road, even with a lot of rain today. This is the only day I could actually go to Uskuli, but okay, just shoot for 3 hours, then it's fine. I really feel pity, I feel really sorry for the hikers here that are walking up here the whole day long in the rain.
Watchtowers. Instead of defending the entire village, a wall around it or a fortress that's protecting the village, each household of every family built their own tower to protect their own house instead of protecting the entire village.
Spending a couple of days in Svaneti, it was time to return inland Georgia and travel to the second largest city of Sakartvelo, Kutaisi. You can spend 1 day in Kutaisi, that is more than enough.
If you are in Georgia, so and you want in the bigger cities like Tbilisi or Kutaisi or Batumi, you can use the Bolt app. It's kind of similar like Uber, but in the Georgia version. Works really fine.
It is a good mix of historic buildings and authentic Georgian life.
Kutaisi is so different from Tbilisi. It feels really old school. Central Asia, Eurasia town. However, I like it actually. So it shows you really the part of the country. Most of the people don't go. They really land here by an airplane and then head off to the mountains. But it's really worth it to visit this entire city from the Soviet, post-Soviet era. This is the market hall, the marketplace. This is a really good insight of the whole daily life here, and I really love it. How the people bargain, how the people live, how the people sell their stuff. Walk from downtown up here. Just not a long walk, and you've really got a beautiful view on Kutaisi itself.
surroundings of Georgia, the Lower Caucasus region, got great highlights as well, like the Okhotsk Canyon and Martvili Canyon.
The whole skywalk is actually vibrating with every footstep you feel here. It's not glass yet. So I'm standing here on the skywalk here at the really end with a really nice viewpoint on the entire canyon. And some people have fear of heights, like Stefan for example.
Not only sightseeing is a must, kayak or swimming the Martvili Canyon is also a possibility.
He's not coming!
Okay. You can have his boat in there.
Okay, we go into the waterfall and then have muchacha, some really strong vodka, chosen vodka. I'm gonna walk down here, it feels a lot colder up here. But this is take two. Stefan is already in. Okay, I'm in it. But the water is a bit warmer, a little bit. But I'm okay. I survived.
As mentioned, I really have to return to this country and visit the surrounding countries. But that is for the future. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe for more travel videos or go to my website thecreativeglobetrotter.nl.